Welcome once again to your channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. I'm your host Mohar, here once again to share with you, all of you, another inspirational story. I personally was much inspired by this story and hence decided to share it with all of you. The story I'm going to share today is about Sala Maradu Timmakka. She is an environmentalist from Karnataka. She was born in 1910-1911, and as was the ritual in those days, at a very young age she was married off to Chikkaya. Now Chikkaya and Timmakka did not have any children, and Timmakka was very depressed because of this. To help her overcome this depression, her husband Chikkaya started inspiring her to plant banyan trees and look after them like her own children. In the first year, they planted about 10 trees, the second year 15, the third year 20, and so on to date between their village Hulikal and till the next village Kudur, they have planted 384 banyan trees and 8,000 other trees in the surrounding areas. Amazing, yeah? No formal education, but a vision to treat plants as their children, trees as their children, especially banyan trees. And together the husband-wife couple planted 8,384 trees, of which 384 trees were planted in rows on two sides of the road connecting their village Hulikal to the next village Kudur. Her husband died in 1991. Despite that, she continued with her practice of being an environmentalist and planting trees in the surrounding areas. Recognition was very slow in coming. In 1995, after 70-80 years of planting these trees and continuing her afforestation efforts, she was given a National Citizens Award in 1995. BBC recognized her as one of the most influential women in 2016, influential and inspirational woman of 2016 by the BBC. Much later in 2019, she got the Padma Shri at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. She is now 109 years old, and you know what? She is planning her next two goals at the age of 109 of constructing a village tank so that this can be used for water during the festivals and fairs they have in the village, and another hospital to be constructed in memory of her husband to give free treatment to the villagers. That's her goal at the age of 108-109 today, when most people think their lives have ended at 65-70. They sit in bed and think that life is going to come to an end. Just count it off on your fingers. You will be amazed. I am inspired by this lady, literally inspired. If I can be 1/10 of what she is, I would be proud of myself. Really, no jokes. I am really inspired by this woman, Timmakka. Let's count. Born in 1910, no formal education, married off as a young girl, no children, and her husband, to inspire her, both started planting trees and looking after them like children. She would carry water 4 kilometers from her village, and her husband would dig the ground, and then Timmakka would plant the trees and water the plants, and both of them together would put thorny bushes around the banyan trees to protect them. They managed to plant between them 384 banyan trees and 8,000 other trees, of which the 384 banyan trees were planted between her village Hullikal and the next village Kudur in a row. After that, she's continuing her efforts. After her husband died in 1991, she continues her efforts with afforestation. And today, at 109, she has two goals of constructing a hospital for her villagers and constructing a tank in her village to help out during festivals and fairs held in her small village. What an inspirational lady. I am totally inspired by her. And an uneducated casual laborer being declared most inspirational and influential woman of 2016, a Padma Shri in 2019. Wow, man. What an inspirational lady. This goes on to prove that you don't require an education, you don't require anything else. What you require is determination, faith, a vision, and you can go places. Nothing else is required. Self-belief, determination, vision. Friends, if you like these inspiring stories of mine, please do subscribe to my channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. And for those of you who are already my subscribers, thank you. I love you. You keep me motivated. Till we meet again with another inspiring story on your favorite channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. Good luck. Stay safe in COVID-19 times. Thank you.